Katrina Mott. I'm a first year doctoral student here at the Harvard Chan School of Public Health in the Department of Epidemiology, and my concentration is pharmacoepidemiology. Before I started my doctoral program, I got a master's degree in epidemiology at the Johns Hopkins School of Public Health, and then I worked for about 3 years at the FDA doing drug safety studies. When I was at Johns Hopkins, I actually concentrated in infectious disease epidemiology, and that led to me doing a master's thesis actually looking at vaccine effectiveness in some in countries across the globe. That got me more interested in thinking about vaccines and drugs and their safety and effectiveness, which is what led me to pursue working at the FDA. It was a great few years at the FDA. I learned a lot and also realized that to sort of continue down this path of being a pharmacoepidemiologist, I really needed to pursue further in my education and get a doctoral degree to eventually either go back to the FDA or potentially work in industry or in academia. So that's why I decided to pursue a doctoral degree and eventually ended up here at the Harvard School of Public Health. When deciding on a doctoral program, I considered a few things. Of course, it's a totally personal decision, and you should think about your goals after your doctoral program, as well as what you want to get out of your program while you're there. For me, I was looking for a place that had a really strong epi methods department or epi methods sequence and classes available. I know that, you know, once you're in the field, the better your methods are, the more opportunities you'll have, the better you'll be able to apply those methods to a variety of different questions, research opportunities, etc. So for me, I was looking for a place that would have plenty of options for classes to take in methods, where I could take much more advanced things, not just for my dissertation, but in all areas of epidemiology. As well, I was thinking about opportunities. And opportunities both after I graduate and throughout the course of my career, but also opportunities while I'm here as a student. Of course, Harvard has a great name, not only in the US, but across the globe, and getting a degree from Harvard means a lot to people. So whether I go into industry or academia or go back to working for the government, I think that I'll have more opportunities because you get a lot of connections. People really value and understand the high quality of education you've received because you have a degree from Harvard. And, you know, I try to be realistic. I may not do pharmacoepidemiology forever. I may not do epidemiology forever. I may switch from doing epi to something that's a combination of, you know, epi and economics, or I may sort of become a manager of some kind and be sort of less focused on research. And I think that outside of epidemiology itself, Harvard has a great reputation overall in all areas, and so people value degrees and people that come and are looking to hire people that come from great universities like Harvard. As well, it was really important to me have a lot of options and opportunities while I'm a student. So I'm in my first year. I don't know exactly what I'm going to do my dissertation on. I have a few ideas, but I definitely wanted to go to a place where I had a lot of options. And Harvard certainly has that. Not only are there many professors that do a variety of different types of research, but Harvard has connections all over Boston and all over the country, and of course across the globe. And so if maybe your advisor doesn't do exactly the project that you want to do, they certainly probably know somebody that does, either across the street at Brigham and Women's Hospital, across the city, or even across the ocean. So being a part of such a large university with great connections means that you have many more opportunities. The university also has great resources. We have access to all kinds of data, different data sets, studies that are, you know, 20 or 30 years old, and access to really awesome labs and research that is being done at Harvard that it's very easy to connect to. One thing that I think Harvard might have a reputation for, it was certainly something that I was worried about coming here, was that because it is such a research-focused university as a whole, and of course here at the School of Public Health, that professors would be under a lot of pressure to produce research, to be publishing, to be presenting at conferences, and they wouldn't really be here very often, that their focus would be on their research and not necessarily on their teaching or their students. And so far I found that to be completely false. It's been one of the things that I've been really pleased with and surprised by in a great way. Professors are very open. They love meeting with students. The classes that I've taken so far, the professors have been teaching them for 20 or 30 years, which I think speaks volumes to how much they love teaching, they love interacting with students, They are always open for setting up office hours or meeting with you outside class. And they put a lot of time and effort into making the courses really high quality. So not only is the coursework really well taught, but in addition, your advisor, other professors are always open to meeting with you. They're very available. It's not hard to get a hold of them. In addition, the EPI department itself has great resources. There's many staff members that are dedicated just to your success as a student and are there for you and your academic success, your emotional well-being, everything to get you through this process of a doctoral program. So certainly if one of your concerns is, you know, that the professors are, you know, less focused on teaching, I don't think that's true at all. I've really been pleasantly surprised by that. So far, so good. I've only been here for a few months. I have a lot of work ahead of me, but I'm really happy with my choice to come to Harvard.